This is the first of two videos for end-stage ACL rehab, and the first thing we're going to do is two legs involving squatting and pivoting. So the first thing you got to do, and this starts at about week 16, is learning how to pivot on your knee. So we're going to do it two legs to start with, and then we'll go one leg later on. But for most people, when they return to sport, they need to be able to make sure that when you turn, you don't leave your foot behind. So when people pivot and turn, they don't want to turn like that, because then if they get an outside force or they crash through there, that's how they're going to re-rupture an ACL or cause an ACL injury in the first place. So what I'm teaching you today is trying to, when you pivot in a squat, as though you were in a position where you're going to get a tackle or you're going to catch a ball, you've got to pivot on your toes. And so your knee has to follow your feet, okay? Because if you leave your foot behind, guess what? You're going to cause that rotational force through your knee. And when your foot is fixed and you're not lifting your head up or pivoting, that's when the problem can occur. So the first exercise is what I call a squat and pivot. So you're in a squat position. Now I'm just holding a ball. The reason I'm doing that is it's very sport specific. So it's like if you're catching a ball or you're holding a racket or something, but this also turns on your core. So this is hard to hold out here, especially out in distance. But one of the main things is if I keep focused on the ball, then I know that I'm not twisting my upper body and leaving my legs behind. Okay, so I've got to try and focus on, I'll show you what I mean, is when I squat like that, I've got to keep this in line with my core trunk. Because the other thing too is I don't want to be twisting under load like that and twisting in my spine when I have load. I want my whole body connected together. So when I pivot, my pivoting is on my toes, okay? I'm not pivoting at my knee and causing a problem there. I'm not pivoting up here. I'm trying to get my whole body core together. So when I pivot, it's on my toes, okay? Now I would start off very slowly. So if this is my ACL knee and I'm focusing on that, I might pivot this way to start with, 45 degrees, and then come back. And you might go that way sort of 10 times, trying to stay in that squat, knees wide, knees over toes, in that position there. And it'll take you a while to get used to it. And then you might go the other way, have a rest, go back down your squat, get your feet right, nicely parallel, and then go the other way. And you'll find with the ACL knee, you'll find one way is definitely, you'll like it better than the other way, and you've got to focus on the way you don't like a lot, okay? So for this way, I don't really like going that way from this knee. I love going this way, that's no problem. And the reason being, because of my ACL knee, when I go lateral, I'm not gonna go any further. The way the knee works, we do a lot of internal rotation on the knee, but not much external, just because of biomechanics. So when I go this way, I don't like it as much because I'm vulnerable here. And I've got to practice making sure that I don't go and crash in there. I've got to stay in my squat and make sure my knee stays over my toe. Okay, so that's your first one. Second thing is do the same thing with the resistance of a band. Now you can just tie it to anything. Come a bit closer, Jules, come look at this. So now, and this is sort of like, it's like a core exercise, right? But I'm trying to do it to train myself to pivot and keep everything together. This is where speed comes in. So once you've done the first exercise, got the control right, then the speed comes in. So I'm in here, and now what I'm going to try and do is not that, but I'm trying to pivot very quickly, okay? And then you can slide back. So this way, you're doing one way at a time, obviously, because the band is to one side, okay? And then turn around and do the other way. So that's a really good way of progressing the control work to adding some speed and some quickness to the movement. And making sure again, knees out over toes, and pivot through there, and back, all right? So that's your squat, pivot, and turn, and that's in a sort of about the week 16 to 19 range.